Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today, I'm going to show you how easy it is to create a really fast dual lighting effect on photos that are normally just standard lighting, but then they can have a two-tone lighting effect inside of Photoshop. And this just takes a couple of minutes, but I'm going to be showing you two different examples in this video. One of the swimmer, which already has a black background, and the other one with a person with a white background. And the reason why I'm showing you two different photos is because with this effect, it's better to use a black and white photo with a black background. But if you don't have a black background, I'm going to show you how you can easily cut out your subject and then place a black background behind it, as well as how to turn your photo into a black and white image. Now, both of these images that I'll be using, you can download to follow along below, or you can use your own photos. But these photos that I'm using were provided by Envato Elements. And Envato Elements, thank you so much for supporting today's video. They set up a specific page for you. There's a link in my description box below where you can get 70% off, which is mostly off your first month, where you can download unlimited assets, whether it's graphic templates or font assets, if you're more of a graphic designer, or if you're a video creator or you make videos about your design, you can get stock video clips, you can get background music, you can get motion graphics elements, and now they have DaVinci Resolve. Not only Premiere Pro, they have DaVinci Resolve and Final Cut Pro, and it's just a really great resource for creators. So thank you so much to Elements for supporting today's video. I highly recommend the tool. I use it in almost all of my videos. And per usual for this tutorial, I always put my time codes down below so that you guys can follow along to make sure that you're going step by step and you're not skipping any sections or if you need to review it. Without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. First, we will start with the portrait of the swimmer here. So first look at the image and you can see where the light is coming from. So you can see on the left, there's some light, and this is where I want to paint kind of a cyan blue color. And then there's some light coming on the right, just behind his shoulder. And this is where I want to paint the red color. So first let's make it black and white by going down to click on an adjustment layer and let's select black and white. And now that it's black and white, let's add some more contrast. To do that, we're going to create a curves adjustment layer, then use this little black triangle here to move it over to the right to add some more darkness to the shadows, and then use the white triangle and move it to the left to increase the brightness. And now you can turn off the visibility of this curves layer to see the result of the contrast. Now the curves are completely optional depending on the photo that you're working with. I just wanted to add a little bit more contrast to this particular photo. So now we need to select a new layer icon to create a brand new layer. And this is the layer that we're going to paint our first color on. So you can choose any two colors that you want. Yellow and purple would be cool too. You can choose two complementary colors that look really nice for your scene. Oh, orange and blue. That's the complement of orange. Orange and blue. So look at your color wheel and you can find your complementary colors. They're opposite of each other in a color wheel, which is pretty cool. So once you have your colors in mind, what I'm going to do is select my first color and I'm going to choose my cyan color. So now you're going to select the brush tool, which is this little paintbrush tool. And you're going to right click on the canvas and you can adjust the brush size. You want this size to be fairly large because we're going to reduce the hardness so that way there's more soft edges to the brush. So what I'm going to do is just click and drag to create my first color strokes on the left side just by painting over the area where the light is naturally coming from. So now we just have this blocky paint area on top of the image. And now we need to go to the blend modes and we're going to change this to color. And now it nicely blends in with our skin. So the color mode is really cool because it allows you to place a color on top of your image and it doesn't affect the brightness of the image. So only the color is on the guy's chest and the face only. And the reason why it's not affecting the background because it's black and there needs to be light there for the color to appear. Because it's completely black, you don't see any of the color in the background. And if you need to, you can, you know, of course, click over this area and paint a little bit more if you want to add some more blue on his chest per se. So now that that's done, let's go ahead and make another layer for our red color. So press the new layer icon and we can name this red and then click on the color selection to change the color to red. And now we're going to go back to the brush tool and paint slowly over the right side of the image. And once again, you're going to go to the blend mode and change it to the color blend mode. And I'm going to also paint a little bit more on the right side on his face just to make that a little bit more bright. You can always undo any strokes that you do by pressing Command plus Z on your keyboard on a Mac or Control plus Z on a PC to undo any of the strokes and then redo them. One more thing you can do is adjust the fill intensity of this color. So you can select the layer and go up to fill and use the slider to adjust the percentage strength. So you can adjust the percentage of the fill to both layers if you want it just a little bit less intense than the full 100%. To see it before and after of how it looked before we added the color, what you can do is select the first effects layer that we created and press Shift to select the last one. And then you can select the folder icon to put all these effects in a folder, and I'll just call this two-tone. And now we can just turn off the visibility of this folder and it will turn off all the effects so you can see the before, and then you can turn it back on to see the after. So now let's go on to the next photo where the background is not completely black. So just like before, we're going to create a new layer and paint our first color red on the right side. Then we're going to change the blend mode to color. You can also see that the color bleeds into the background because it's not completely black. You may actually like the color bleeding into the background, and that's completely fine. But if you don't want it bleeding in the background, I'm going to show you how to remove the background and replace it with black in just a moment. And now I'm going to create another layer, and we're going to select our cyan color and paint on the left side just like before. And once the painting is done, we're going to go to change the blend mode to color. So you might like how this looks. It looks really cool with the color bleeding in the background, in my opinion, but if you want the kind of black background look, let's separate our subject from the background so we can remove the background and replace it with black. So to do this, we first should turn off our color layer visibility and then select our image layer. Then you can go up to quick actions and you can simply click on the remove background icon here. But I think selecting the subject is actually better than just removing the background because I'm able to add some more fine-tuned selection before I remove the background. So once it's selected, you can then zoom in to your image and use the hand tool by pressing H on your keyboard to inspect the edges. And you can use the quick selection tool to select more parts or remove unwanted parts of the selection by pressing the Alt or Option key on a Mac when you click to remove parts of the selection. If you're dealing with an image where somebody has a lot of wispy hairs and more complex hairs, I've actually made a full tutorial on how to carefully remove the background and cut out hair accurately. So I'll put a card up here to that video if you want to watch how to do more complex selections. So once the selection is done, go up to select modify and feather, and I'm going to add just a slight feather. You can play around with this, but around 4 or 5 worked just fine. And then after that's done, you're going to press Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC to make the selection its own layer. And then we can turn off the background layer. And we can now create a new layer. And this is going to be our background layer, and let's move this underneath our selected foreground. And then we can apply a solid layer effect to this layer, and let's fill it in black. And we can zoom in to see if any edges need to be cleaned up. You can go to the eraser tool and right click to make sure the hardness is low, and you can carefully groom and smooth over any of those rough edges just by using the eraser tool. And then you can press Command plus 0 or Control plus 0 to bring it back fully in frame. And then you can turn the color layers back on because now the background is pure black and no color is bleeding in the background. So now you have your final effect. So here we use two different photos, right? And I showed you how easy it is just to use the brush tool and change the color blend mode to color to easily create this effect. Of course, you know, you might want to change the fill intensity a little bit, but the same thing can be applied to almost any portrait photo that you want to create. So if this effect helped you out or inspired you, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, as well as subscribe and hit that notification bell so you guys are notified when I publish more tutorials on the channel. So thanks again to Envato Elements for supporting today's video. You can get 70% off using my discount link just down below to get unlimited downloads. It's a great deal. And
when you're stuck and you're not moving forward, Envato Elements is the place for you. You get unlimited downloads, freedom to explore, templates, photos, music, just everything you need. Envato Elements, yeah, the new way to create.
So that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and keep creating better video with Gal. Bye.